Can you tell Brandon not to burn down the forest, please?
Trees aren't people.
If you want to try and burn down the forest, Brandon, be my guest.
No.
He'd probably just burn you alive.
It's enrichment for George, all right?
They're like evil or something.
I guess the commander said no, therefore I can't do it.
No. Fuck around and find out.
That's not the right tone. Don't fucking do it. Don't listen to it.
I do like finding out.
You
one of my second favorite pastimes. Love finding out.
If you don't find out, how are you ever supposed to get smarter?
Yeah, it's all a learning process.
It's all a learning process.
You just gotta balance it out. And, you know, understanding these trees and how they burn down is a good step to learning.
Exactly.
Okay.
I think that Brandon, he's got an idea.
Journeyman, give me them cocktails.
I don't know.
Fireball.
Sure.
If you want to burn down the entire Omen Wield, Brandon, I'm sure that would be awesome for you.
Is it Omen Wield or Omen Wield?
Omen Wield, a wield, like a forest.
Wield. Yeah. I didn't know that's what that meant at all.
Yeah, a wield, a forest. So the name for it. Or like a wild land.
Cool. I learned so much in your campaigns. Yeah. Mostly words.
Mostly words.
Mostly new words.
Yeah.
That's pretty good.
I try to increase the vocabulary. Bit by bit.
Ugh.
Can't pronounce that word.
In here.
Brandon.
Huh?
Is Zay ready for open heart surgery?
Oh, calm down there.
Everything surgery?
I don't know about the open heart surgery, but that will be pretty interesting of your definition of heart.
Hey, what are you doing?
Absolutely fucking nothing. Stay in your lane.
No. This is my lane. What are you talking about?
Listen.
We were gonna do the whole see how recovery helps, and they will take blood samples throughout the entire process to get more details on how it works. Yeah. Well, I was thinking, I was like, well, why not at that point also just get a look at the entire body and all of the insides and how everything operates while that's happening.
You want to do exploratory surgery?
Listen,
Varus told us not to do this.
I am no medical professional.
Exactly.
What? I mean, it wouldn't just be you, Zay. It would be hands-on.
For who?
I don't know. Probably Magion and the other doctors that exist in the Brigade.
Magion's not a doctor.
Magion is a material god who can keep me from dying.
All right. I think we need to pump brakes.
Yeah, I don't know what drugs you're on. I agreed to one thing, not all this. We don't need to look at your whole body.
I'm just saying, it could give a lot of information. And also, Key's, you know, it honestly wouldn't be the worst thing Key's been through.
I'm vetoing this.
As a fellow vetoer, I agree.
There's also some other ideas.
We're
too.
Not cutting you open.
Why not?
Let me rephrase that. We're cutting the arm open, and that's where we're looking at the blood as this process works out. I'm not gonna look at your fucking heart.
You're doing open arm surgery?
Absolutely. Well,
I don't
know. You're not a doctor.
If it's just blood drawing. Well, I mean, Zay actually came to some really awesome conclusion with the blood testing.
Does he have intimate anatomical knowledge to do?
Athena.
Yes.
How did doctors learn about open heart surgery, right? They had to try it first, okay?
Exactly.
But they usually had previous knowledge of
How did that knowledge get found?
The fact that the House of Wisdom used cadavers.
So they're jumping a few steps. All right, this is how science is, you know, advances. All right.
Yes, exactly.
No, Jon Snow would say otherwise. Not the Game of Thrones Jon Snow, the scientist.
Do I think I care about Jon Snow? I don't know.
Yes, sounds like a fucking nerd.
He prevented cholera. He's the foundation of germ theory.
Cauliflower.
I could solo cholera, who cares?
Solo cholera.
Bro, you can't even solo
I don't
solo
know how vegetables
ADHD.
Have anything to do with
how
this.
How are you
going to
solo
cholera? Whoa.
It's just a disease, alright? I just cough it out.
That's Game not how over. Cholera
like,
works.
Like an organ?
Cholera makes you shit your organs out.
Yeah, I'm going to cough
this
it out.
This is I don't eat cauliflower.
Cauliflower does not give you cholera.
You look down and you're like, oh, that's my lung. It came out through my ass.
That's why I'm coughing. It's gonna go out. I know what I'm doing.
And so does Key.
I'm not touching your fucking heart.
I wanna see the organs.
Wait.
I wanna see my organs. My body, Whoa. My choice. My body, my choice.
I have a really cool show
you awake for it?
That you should watch.
I have a bunch of people here that are saying, my body, my choice. That's not real. It's not real at Regent University. It's the Lord's body, Peter.
Oh my god.
It's our
body. Oh my god.
It's our body, comrade.
It's our body.
And you know, God doesn't send us to hell. We send ourselves to hell
Correct.
Through our choices.
Uh-huh. Now, did God tell us explicitly which choices are good and bad? And, give
Bible.
Us the opportunity for sin? Yeah, he did, but, you know.
Sin?
It's okay.
No, not
sin
that guy.
Was destroyed.
Not that guy.
Yeah.
Don't worry. Some individuals saw to that.
I veto sin's death.
I'm gonna blow this ring up.
Yeah, but I veto your veto.
Damn.
I veto you.
Don't you like being vetoed?
Yeah.
Only when I have the power to do it and no one else.
Uh-huh. So that's not how democracy works?
Well, dictatorship.
Dictatorships don't have vetoes, Brandon. Go back to government class.
You just veto them out of existence.
And you're not getting it. Still not getting it. We'll get there eventually, maybe, one day. I don't know if today's that day. We're already on some very strange energy.
I'm full of energy.
Break my ribs. Open my chest.
Uh-huh.
I mean, Charon could probably do that. Charon's not a doctor, but I think they'd get it.
Okay, mini banker.
Maybe I'm just excited to get to zero corruption. That's gonna be exciting for Key. It's been so long. Every morning, I just hack up this like black goo and go about my day.
Smoker's lung.
Yeah, just no one asks.
Asking Key about things can have it can be bad for your mental health, I think.
Yeah, that's also fair.
Fuck.
Something
you good?
Something good?
Brandon? You good, Brandon?
Yeah, I'm gonna ask you something.
Yeah. There he goes. Alrighty.
So, are
he
you
is
guys...
the most ethical person I know.
Are y'all ready, though, to begin our little down, not technically a downtime session.
Downtime.
But this is just such an easy session, you know?
So easy.
Nothing bad's gonna happen.
At all.
You're just going...
I was ready until you said that.
He's just trying to manipulate you.
I am, Caleb.
I mean, he always is.
Of course. Like, it's fine. It's fine.
Master.
A slip o' the tongue. But where we pick up is with a monkey. His name is George. And he was given a very important mission by Mace Crane to go check out a monument. A derelict monument. Exactly! And now he's gotta assemble his team. So how is George doing that?
Well, we all know George can't really speak. At least not conventionally. So he would probably collect a bunch of... No, he would draw. Would draw a bunch of maps of the base of Widow's Gunkeep. With a giant red circle of where he wants everyone to meet up. And he would kind of run around and deliver the maps to everybody.
Okay. That makes sense. So, my assumption is then everyone is meeting up. Following the map given by the monkey.
And we'll do it.
I tell the maiden that a monkey has delivered me a quest. And I tell her if she needs anything to call for Andreas.
Okay.
And then I go.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
And then she just goes back to sitting. But everyone's meeting up?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Then all of you find George in the designated meeting place.
Yeah.
What are you guys doing?
We're just sitting there. He's got a little makeshift table, a very crude map with like twigs and stuff, and then little rocks. And he's got a piece of paper that has Operation Derelict kind of like written out.
Uh huh.
And he's on the table, you know, walking around, hands behind his back, trying to look very important, very, you know, high up.
He is very important.
Yeah. So, Commander, what's up?
George will hand Charon the operation paper and just begin talking off and like signing in his monkey ways.
I try to make a mental check to understand sign language.
Yeah, I'd like all of you to make mental
checks. Fuck yes!
George,
yes.
To try and understand.
Great.
I'm so happy.
Yeah, I want to do that. Can I get Exceptional Mind for this?
Yeah.
Four?
Fucking nothing.
A four, a five?
Let's see.
0 on 7?
Nothing. On my singular d6.
One.
Okay.
I think I might be the person who got... Oh, no, I think I'm the person who got one. One of the people.
Yeah, you both did.
Yeah.
Angel, you and I just make eye contact and we're like... We're both clearly struggling.
No. Those of you who got ones are experiencing the Dunning-Kruger effect. You believe you understand. But you are not understanding. You do not have the skill required to actually understand what the monkey is trying to convey. Those who rolled nothing, you're like, I don't get it. But those who rolled one, you're like, I'm perfectly translating this monkey. Only Charon can actually understand, like, George to a degree and pick up on what he's trying to convey. But I leave the Dunning-Kruger crew to their own imagination for what they think is trying to be conveyed.
Charon's nodding along. Very, very matter-of-fact.
Okay,
Angel's
okay.
Also
okay.
Nodding along. Very matter-of-fact.
So you want us to explore a cave nearby?
I didn't see anything about a cave. Where was the
cave?
You
know, like, No. When he put his hands,
yeah,
exactly. That was O for the opening of a cave.
I make eye contact with George and I hand over the paper to them.
This is wrong because this doesn't say anything about a cave, Charon. This can't possibly be what he means.
I don't.
Yeah, no. Look, there's some sort of creature in the cave, and we need to. I think it's
we have to slay it. Yes, yeah. Yes. No, I'm picking up on that.
What the fuck is going on here?
No,
that slicing motion and the pulling.
Exactly. And then that motion with like the hands on the chest, that was for like the herb medicine part of it. Yeah, no. I see what you mean, Angel. That makes sense.
Okay. So, I don't think you guys are getting it.
What are you talking about? We're getting this perfectly.
No, there's a tree, a white one, I think, very, really far out. There's a moss we need to acquire for Crane.
A tree for Crane. Where did you get white?
I don't know what to tell you. I'm a ghost trapped to a book. Ooh. There's weirder things.
I mean, as I'm seeing it, it's like 2-1, no offense, Charon. And I, me and Angel, we feel very confident about this deduction right now.
Charon looking at the wrong mission.
George, just nod or... Can you give us a sign if we're on the right track, George?
George is dumb right now. Give him a second.
No, he just said that was the wrong mission. I really thought that didn't look like the paper, but that is what he said.
I think it's funny if George passed over the wrong mission paper. To Charon.
Yeah. George snatches the paper back and pulls out a pouch full of papers and like begins ruffling through them real quick.
What the fuck? Back
to Charon.
This is so dumb.
Oh my god.
Oh.
We're doing Derelict.
See, yeah, Charon, so... you're making him flustered. He's trying his best.
What the fuck did I do?
You embarrassed him. What?
You embarrassed him, obviously.
I'm gonna
look at him through his tiny bag. There's so many papers in there. He's trying so hard.
George wipes clear the map that he had worked on and like begins like trying to reassemble and build another map for this mission.
Oh no, George! It was great. You were doing great.
He's literally not mad about this at all. I don't understand. He's just fine.
Karen, you're clearly not picking up on the nuances of George. Angel, don't you agree that he looks flustered right now?
Okay, so I'm gonna go get ready for the mission, and I'll see you guys later. Karen walks up.
I think that's the best, Karen.
Right?
Huh?
Altair is the giant, right, Jonah?
Yeah.
I just looked at you. What the fuck are they talking about? What is going on?
He'll look down, look back up. I zoned out about 3 minutes ago. I don't know what's going on.
Man, he's just like me for real.
Oh, I suppose when George leads us out, we will see that he's leading us to the cave.
Exactly, exactly. And if it's anything else, then we just must not be in the right place then.
He's telling us not to doubt ourselves.
Can I make a spirit check to see how the monkey is feeling?
Make a spirit check.
Okay. Two successes.
Gotcha. Keenan, can you send me three possible emotions that George can be feeling at this moment? One actual, two that are not actual. And Jonah, I would like you to choose one, two, or three.
Should I wait till after they're sent?
Well, it's going to be sent no matter what, so.
Okay.
Please put flustered. It'd be so funny if he accidentally got flustered.
We'll do just smack dab in the middle, number two.
He's so happy at the moment. Just ecstatic that, you know, everything is going so well.
I'll turn a look, give a nod of approval, and head off to go prepare. He thinks everything is fine. The monkey is happy.
All right, so Keith, since we're going into a cave, I think we're going to need torches.
I agree. And, you know, hope is always good. And yeah, no. I think that's smart. I'll go get some torches.
Hey, Key, instead, how about we go do the thing?
Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm sorry, Angel. Could you take care of that? I have to get my blood drawn, like, 6 times.
Oh, yeah, good luck.
Thanks. And Key will head off with Zay.
Okay.
If George's alone now, George can begin playing with the map that he's now set up. That is not the correct map. Begin working out his little plan.
Are there little figurines of each of us?
They're little rocks, yeah.
I love that so much.
It's so good. It's so good. It's perfect. Well, with this out of the way, what are people doing? Well, firstly, actually, for anything else, Keenan, my commander, roll 2d6. Or actually, roll 1d6.
Yeah, I got you.
Four. Random event. Roll a d20.
Uh-oh.
Yippee.
Yay, do it.
Mm.
Oh,
that was really close to a one.
I mean, it's probably fine. Let me just see what we got here.
Everyone goes on a murderous rampage.
I mean, probably not, right?
God, I hope not.
I hope. What is this? Oh! Spy network collapse.
Oh, mother.
A spy network dies, and your network loses an upgrade.
Fuck.
I'm going to start flinging poo.
Yep, as you're alerted, which spy do you want to die?
Oh, fuck.
Antoinette was your first spy. She's been with you since the start.
We should kill her.
If we pay to get another level 1 spy, could that level 1 spy then die?
We have to choose one right now.
Yeah, it's right now.
So there's Antoinette, and then there's
Fortis and Mark.
Yeah, it goes Mark. Level 2, level 3, level 3.
And Antoinette was our first one.
What do I...
How much of a monster are you?
Well, you're putting a lot of stress on a chip, all right? So, give him a second.
I'm putting a lot of stress on a human man who is a soldier in the army.
I'm gonna eeny, meeny, miny, mo this.
Oh no. Just kill the first.
God, it's the army's finest, truly.
Be the monster.
All right, it's gonna go Antoinette, Bordas, Mark. Mm-hmm. 1, 2, 3.
Mark, no! Mark.
Rip Mark.
Late name, anyways.
Then Mark goes missing, and then, as well, the network loses an upgrade. Which upgrade do you want lost? So you've got sources, exploratory ventures, field assessment. I would not recommend you deleting the base one, spy network, because that allows you to be able to train, support, and utilize spies.
Yeah.
But potentially that might be something you want to do if you're like, actually, we just don't need it for this mission.
Just a true
collapse.
And it's a supply and a morale to upgrade, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I think. I think field assessment might be.
That would get rid of exploratory ventures, though.
Oh, would it? Would we not get to keep exploratory ventures? Oh.
I think we might just have to go sources.
But that's.
Yeah, but we can't provision, though.
I feel like we should get rid of exploratory ventures. Sources and field assessment are...
The thing is, I see us getting this upgrade back, like, this session. Because if we want to get emeralds, we need exploratory ventures. And losing our level 3 dude is... That's smart. Oh, that's so rough. Okay. I'm thinking we're gonna have to get exploratory, like, whatever we lose, we're gonna have to get again with morale and supply.
So the exploratory ventures, is that the general consensus?
If we get rid of it and then get it back again, do we get to use it for this mission?
For this? Yeah, you could do that.
I mean, they all cost the same, yeah, right?
They all cost the same. There's an order to them, but... Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then, I mean, getting rid of exploratory ventures is fine if we just want to call it that and we just immediately buy it again.
Yeah.
But, like, if we weren't buying it again, I would probably do sources. Because, I mean, we just want emeralds anyway. Like, we need to be able to, like, get things, but I think the amount that we get, as long as we get something, it's good. That's my onion.
Well,
it's a good onion.
We're getting double with whatever we find here, so if we do go, I think we can lose.
Does the Rainbow Boon apply to the Spy Network yield, or just to the rewards you get from the mission?
Just rewards from missions.
Gotcha.
Let's just do exploratory ventures.
Yeah.
Buy back.
Yeah.
Exploratory ventures.
Just buy back.
If we have a spy for this mission.
If we have a spy master for this mission, correct. We know George is the commander. Do I have a marshal?
I'll take up Marshall.
All right. Do I have a lore keeper?
Caleb's written.
I can take it. Yep.
Okay.
Or if someone else wants to take it, I don't mind, but I did put myself down for it.
Fair.
Do it.
Then, do I have a spymaster?
I can do it. Or right. Someone else, but...
Do I have a quartermaster?
I can do that.
Gotcha.
I suppose.
Then, any pre-mission work that y'all are wishing to do?
I'm donating blood to the cause.
Blood?
Blood?
I...
All right, then we'll handle you first. What is the, are you trying to get opened up for this?
I was seeing if we could do a little cut in the arm and put the microscope on that and just look at the process being
put
done.
Put the microscope in the arm?
Not in the arm, but over the arm where the cut that's is. Not...
I don't think you know what a microscope is.
Yeah, that's not how that works.
That's not how
usually you'd like take a sample, like you
put it on a little glass.
You'd have to cut it really thin and put it on a glass plate. They're like really small gaps.
That would be quite a lot.
Are you wishing to take samples then?
Yes.
You want to like punch a hole in some muscles?
Well, I mean, first. He would ask Zhang if this process would yield any greater results if it was, you know, you could open me up and see all the little bits as they get uncorrupted.
I don't know if I can see it without the real the microscope. I can try to feel the process being done with my magic, but...
Oh, I mean more like having other doctors there as well to check on that process while you do the blood research.
Oh, I mean, I think that's the whole thing that would need to be
okay.
A lot of resources for its own mission.
Would it be a good idea to open you up right before a mission?
Yeah.
You can handle it.
No. Just listen. May I supply that this disease, we have just learned, is a blood disease. Take the blood out, put it on the microscope slide, and look at it. We don't really need to be looking at what the other organs are doing right now, because it's...
You never know until you try.
Until you try.
I give up. Alright, do whatever you want. Cut your arm open. Take a stamp out of your...
Say we would like to study the effects of recovery on the person through... all the stages throughout we the get. Process. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This sounds like I'm fine.
Yeah, as I'm imagining it, I'm going to need 5 recovery to fully get down to 0. Basically, during and after each recovery, a blood sample is taken, looked at, and that process continues.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Zay, make a mental check at detriment 2.
So I still get the benefits from the microscope and everything?
For this, you get benefit 1 from the microscope.
And then 1 from science, or just we'll keep it at 1?
For this, yeah, you get another from science.
Alright. 5 dice then. Or 6 dice.
That's good.
Hey.
Ooh,
that's pretty good.
I'll spend the 2 hero points.
1.
1.
Oh, 1. Okay.
Hey.
Let's go.
This does absolutely nothing extra.
Cool.
Like,
wow.
You already kind of knew how it works. So. Like, the way the recovery works is by isolating the virus and then, like, basically ripping it apart
mm-hmm.
For those purposes. That's information you already knew. In order to improve it, you'd have to either get yourself a Nexus to learn more about the connections between the virus, or... study different ways that may be able to more effectively tear this virus apart. But, like, actually seeing how the recovery works, it works the same as normal medicine, just for this particular disease.
Understood.
Could we... like, partway through the process, could we do a little pivot?
No, I think we should just get to the mission. Let other people do their things.
What is pivot?
Yeah, okay.
I'm trying to see if this is not, like, I don't know if this is necessarily knowledge that he would have. Well, I'm not even sure if it's knowledge that I can speak of. I'm just going to message you real quick.
Okay.
I'm just not sure if that's something I would, as a character, would even think about, but...
Yeah, I don't think that'd be something you'd be able to, think about or know about, given the recentness of all of this. And you just not having a lot of good connections to that. But what I do need you to do is make a spirit save for me.
Okay. That's two.
Okay.
I can re-roll if needed.
Do you want to re-roll?
Good things come in threes. I'll re-roll. Start two. Okay, I got four successes.
Gotcha. And you're good there?
I think that's okay. I hope it is.
Mm-hmm. Then yeah, it's a lot of blood is taken and it's a little invasive what's going on, but you're not going to lose any stamina or gain any levels of tired based on all this work that's being done.
Let's go!
And I'll take the samples and put them in the freezer.
Gotcha. So you have a lot of samples. Like, now you have at least a database of like what the process of recovery looks like, but again, like, you've gone as far as you can with the information available to you. You're gonna have to start introducing other factors.
Yep.
Okay.
But with those two doing their thing, anybody else have things they're doing before the mission starts?
I would like to request the use of two recovery to get my health blocks back, please. Does anyone have issues with this?
Yeah, I fucking guess. Go do it.
Thank you. Silly I'm sitting man. At one.
What a goober.
I'm there dragging himself to the meeting point.
I guess it would be also the recovery on Key as well.
They already did it.
It looks like that was already deducted.
Oh shit. Oh okay, yeah. Never mind. I'm blind.
Can I go see if my associate would like to or is free?
Your associate is free.
I would like to train. If there are people at the training grounds, I don't particularly want to go in there, so I think we said that there was a outside space. That was still covered by the mist heart, so I would go out there for privacy.
Going out there for privacy. Yeah, certainly possible, certainly possible. Then, for this...
What, Jonah?
Is something wrong, Jonah? You good, Jonah?
I'm gonna kill that rat.
Are you gonna manage
this?
It's more than saying sorry.
Then go ahead here and you can make a spirit check as you are led through connecting with the base of this power.
Since I have done this before, do I get anything additional?
Yes, but we'll get to that.
Okay, so just my standard
mm-hmm.
roll?
But you have not gotten the first part of it yet, right?
Yeah, that is true. Mm-hmm. Yes, I don't believe so.
Yeah, from what I have here, it's just you needing some spirit.
I'll re-roll two for funsies.
All right.
It's a lot of sixes.
Four.
Then, yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. Roll an additional, let's see, what is Charon's power score?
Oh, wait, did I just say yes to this thing you sent me?
Yeah.
I thought you were just asking me yes or no. Okay. Yeah, sure.
All right, what's Charon's power score?
Five.
Roll that many extra d6.
Oh, God.
What are you doing?
One.
Gotcha. In that case, you are able to unlock the first step. Congratulations. Let me go ahead and send to you what it does.
Oh! Ah. How exciting. Would it be possible for me to procure a bit of cheese for my friend?
Mm-hmm.
I do that.
Gotcha.
And I'll... Do I have my... I assume I have my own room, right?
Mm-hmm.
Would he prefer to stay back here and just hang out in my room, or does he mind coming along?
Likely. Doesn't seem like he particularly likes going outside.
Okay, yeah. Then I'll shut him in my room.
Okay.
If he's cool, then. Yeah.
Then, with Charon doing that, anybody else having things that they wish to try and accomplish?
Does the recovery prevent me from doing something else?
No.
Okay, can I... It's Margot that gives the spirit, or the ward, right?
Mm-hmm.
Would I be able to go talk to her?
Sure. You wanting to engage in a conversation, or are you just trying to get the ward?
I don't think they've ever talked, so, like, we could if you wanted, but I don't particularly care.
All right, then she'll just get you the ward as you're coming through.
Oh. Bet. It's resistance 1 to magic.
And spiritual damage.
Magic and spirit. Cool.
And then
would Angel... Yeah, would they be able to find Charon, or with her going somewhere to train, is that probably, would she not be around?
Yeah, Charon's probably not around. Maybe like towards the very end of this period.
Towards the very, that's okay. They were going to ask Charon for help with something after the actual mission, but they wanted to talk about it now.
Okay.
So towards the end of this period, they would probably head to probably Charon's room first, and then checking by the maiden's area if Charon's not in there.
I'm like, Charon would be in their room, but I don't think they would answer.
Mm.
Sorry, the roommate was talking to me. Trying to get my attention.
In a roundabout way, you are finally able to get Charon's attention, Angel.
Oh, Charon. Right, I was hoping to ask you for a favor.
Yeah, I do favors.
Right, You're rather stealthy. Would you be willing to help me? After this mission, I'm trying to get into somewhere I'm not exactly allowed to go in. I was wondering if you could help me with that.
Aaron looks left and right for a sign of Magion, and then gives you like a really large grin. Okay. Can I have more detail?
Yeah, I was hoping to get into the prison to speak to Radovan.
And do you want to do this after?
After the mission. I figure George will want us to be heading out soon.
I might have to check a few things when we get back, but I don't think it would be impossible to try.
I appreciate it. Thank you. Radovan's been helping me with something. And I would like to continue that. I can fill you in later. I just feel like now isn't, or this place isn't necessarily great for going into detail.
Yeah, I was about to say my toll is information, but you beat me to it. Let's go.
All right.
Gotcha. Then anything else people are doing, or we good?
Would Angel, since they still think they're going caving, would they be able to pick up some torches?
Sure.
Cool. that's a little key they would. Okay.
Do, do we plan on moving at night? Because it's recon?
Don't know. I suppose.
Oh!
Yeah.
Give me a second to figure this out.
I don't know how I feel about going out there at night, considering what's currently out there. I'd like to be able to see, but...
Yeah.
Sight is overrated.
Hold on. Wait a second.
Hold up. Wait a minute.
Yeah, no, we're gonna do it at day.
We're gonna do it at day? Interesting, okay.
How is the monkey supposed to swing between the trees?
Exactly.
Okay.
Then, let's run through the list. Spymaster, any upgrades to the spy network?
Wow, how'd you know?
A new spy.
A new spy touches the brigade.
We will be getting exploratory ventures back.
Okay.
Do you just want to swing for the fences and get another spy?
Oh.
I mean, I think we could wait on that.
Yeah, sure. I think we're okay for now.
Okay, I mean, it'll never be, like, good odds for a level one spy.
Yeah. Just, I want to have more morale.
That's also very fair, because we also, because there's random events, we don't know if, like, shit will hit the fan or something.
Any change to the assignments?
Emeralds.
Yeah, I must switch propaganda to emeralds.
Okay.
I think.
Fair enough.
And then... Let's see. Where's my list of things? Yeah, I think that's fine as it is.
All right, then roll 46.
Yay!
Wow, that's abysmal.
Yeah, that ain't that great. However, again, not too bad, given, you know, you got some upgraded spies in the mix. That will be 2 emeralds and 1 supply.
Yay.
Yippee.
We regained our loss. That's good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Well,
part of it.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I was mostly worried about the emerald that we were using on this mission.
All right. Mm-hmm. But Quartermaster, you doing anything?
Ooh. That's a good question. Let's see.
Ryan had thoughts for the therapy tent. Just throw it out there.
I did want to step. Can you start multiple projects at once, or is it only one per thing?
So for the projects, it is 2 points to start a new project.
2 points to start, okay.
You get 3 total.
I will take the binoculars, and I'll hand them to George.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we necessarily need anything else from there. I will start Andreas's therapy zone.
Therapy
as a project, if that's okay.
Yep.
Therapy, tent, building, whatever. Whatever happens.
Fair.
Becomes a new brigade hotspot.
And I suppose I just put the last credit into that one?
Sure, yeah. Then right. Therapy zone project in effect. Then I will ask Commander, are you spending any intelligence? For this thing that we call a mission.
Yeah. I'm gonna have a huddle real quick. I'm thinking about what's a challenge we might face on this mission. I don't want to use up all our intel.
Is that a level 1 or level 2?
Level 2. Because I feel like all the level 1s are pretty, like, we all know.
I like it.
At least have an idea.
I mean, we're going to get double intel from this.
If that's fine, then, if that's what you want to do.
I'm good with it.
What's a challenge we might face on this mission?
Well, let's go in order, because you have 2 questions. So, anything from first level?
No.
Okay.
You have a free question.
Let me look at this.
Like, a useful
item. Not wasting that.
Okay. You just get a free question.
2 approaches, useful item.
Oh, that's free? I thought, yeah.
You pay 2
for it.
Yeah, you spend 2, you get 2 and 1.
1 intel and 1 2 intel.
Yeah.
Session 85. I think useful item or how dangerous is this mission would probably be, I think either of those would be good.
What, 2 approaches and 1 to 10?
I said useful item, but I mean, useful. If you want to do 2 approaches, I don't mind.
Let's do on a scale from 1 to 10, how dangerous?
2?
Alright. Very cool.
A very solid, low 2 to high 1.
Right on.
We're right here.
We can bring it up to a 9, guys.
Just in your mouth. Ask your question, too. Let's get this rolling.
Yeah, what's a challenge we might face?
challenge you might face a way of unlocking the secrets within the monument and satisfying the conditions for entry.
Okay.
And then,
useful item probably would have been a good question there.
One
Sorry,
more question from the Spymaster.
Well, there you go.
Did they get rid of that one is the question. Nope, it's still there. Yep.
Huh?
I just wanted to make sure that field assessment was the one they gave it to you.
I mean, yeah, do we want to do useful item? Or I can do another one from two.
Useful item.
That would be my thought, at least.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, I feel a little weird doing a one intel one when we have enough for a two intel one, but I feel like it would be, given the answer we just got, it probably would be very pertinent.
That or skill set, but that might be...
I'd just do the
item. Yeah, I'm going to do... What would be a useful item?
Something that affects light.
Something that affects light.
Ooh, can we trust mirrors? No, right?
I mean, here we haven't had.
No, we did.
I don't. We did, but I don't know if it's still ongoing.
Oh, it is.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Which actually might be a little helpful for this. It's too bad Fidelis isn't on this mission, though.
Yeah.
Hey, I have water that can reflect.
Yeah, is it mirrors or reflective surfaces?
No. Reflective surfaces that have a clear reflection.
Okay.
And what exactly... And that's just basically a way for the Dark Star's power to, like, pass through, right?
That allows the impure to come through. They can come through any reflection of adequate clarity.
Are there any mirrors still in the brigade?
All right, it's 11. We should get out of here.
Sorry.
Did we want to try and find an item? Do we have an item?
I mean,
we have a diamond.
I mean, I still think the torches might be useful for, like, casting shadows and affecting light that way. I don't know what else we...
I mean, yeah. All right, that's fine.
Unless we can make a prism.
A diamond?
I mean, that'd be...
Is it a cut diamond or is it a raw diamond? I don't know. We're fine. We'll just use torches. Okay.
All right. Then... Commander, go ahead and make the engagement roll.
You mean Marshall?
Or Marshall, sorry.
No, it's fine. I didn't want duties anyway. okay, are we all loyalty to the... What the fuck?
See, I called the right person.
My poor mother called me and I hanged up on her.
Hung up on
Dang.
Her.
Dang.
I'm gonna hang myself. All right,
you will have hung yourself.
Brigade loyalty. Is everyone here loyal?
Yes.
I hope so.
Yeah. We're all sworn members.
We've spent at least one intel.
Mm-hmm.
Has everyone survived the Battle of Widowstone or above level 15?
Yep.
Yep.
Does a member of the brigade distract another in the squad or not respect leadership enough to obey orders on the battlefield?
I don't think so. Sorry.
Yeah, I was gonna say me too, just after that fiasco at the beginning.
Oh, I wasn't even thinking about the beginning of this session.
No. Parameters. Do we have all parameters?
You do.
Cool.
Our section is lower than 4.
Mm-hmm.
It is? Okay, cool. This is a culture and recon, or is it just a recon?
cultural and recon, I believe.
Okay. Do all members of the squad have a moon speed at least 50? Nope.
Nope.
We're not moving at night. Culture? Did the quartermaster spend a relic or an NPC gift a ward this mission? I'm guessing, does that ward count as Margo?
No.
Nope.
Okay, gotcha.
And no relic was spent.
If a member of the brigade is suffering from corruption, is anyone, Angel? Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So we're sitting at two dice.
Nice. Then, as everyone is beginning to head out, you can go ahead and roll 2d6 for me.
Ha!
Huh. Oh, no.
I love it. I love it, guys.
So great here.
How's that danger level now?
I mean... Hold on, let me see something.
Strong 2.
What the fuck?
So, as you all exit the brigade... It is very quickly clear that you are all not alone here in these woods. And you spend the better part of your journey avoiding Ruvor as you're making your way through. After hours of running in this place, all of you lose 50 stamina points, gain tired 1, and I will give you the option. Detection goes up by 1, or supplies go down by 2. Up to you.
Question. What if we don't have 50 stamina points?
Well, then you go to 0 and you get an additional tired.
Okay. So, tire 2.
Mm-hmm.
Great.
I personally would vote we lose the supply.
My vote's on supply.
Gotcha. Then, this, because of the... Yep. Let me see here. Yeah, because of the doubling... factor in this. It is a mission cost, since we're in the mission, so you lose 2 supply.
This I thought you were about to say 4.
Yeah, I was really worried you were about to say 4.
Oh, that's right, because it is 4. Sorry. Sorry, I had to yank your chain a bit, but it is 4. However,
Would it be 1 detection or 2 detection then?
It would have been 2 detection if you chose.
Gotcha.
Yeah, I think supply is still the move then, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm.
However, as you continue on, at this point it's closer to about 3 o'clock. And in the distance you can see a strange sight as you kind of push through the tree cover. There is an old, run-down, like, stone structure. It is tucked in kind of a small valley, as indicated on the maps. There are pillars kind of scattered about this place, and what appears to be a raised dais of some kind in the middle. Kind of a stairway going up, and then like this stone dome structure as well. It's a very strange place that is almost completely overtaken by the woods and the forest, and you don't know if the Ruvor are completely lost from your tail, since the highest you rolled was only a 2. But you've come to this location.
Fantastic. Could we take a look at the dais and the pillars, kind of see if there's any symbols on them? Anything carved into them?
I mean, you can walk up to something and try and see.
Yeah. Actually, I'll head over to this one first.
This is what, again?
You walk up there and see.
Okay.
And I'm assuming for this, you're all going up the actual stairs. You're not, like, climbing up as...
Yeah.
Oh, okay, sorry. That's stairs. Gotcha. There you go.
But as you go up, there appears to be here... kind of this circular raised altar that is carved out of stone, and there are a series of like gemstones of all different types like embedded in the stone as well, and the gemstones twinkle a little bit in the light. What catches your eye most though, Altair, is like, it appears like there is both a sun and a moon symbol on this kind of raised structure. The moon partially covering the sun.
What phase is it in? Full, or...?
It's like a crescent moon, it seems like, that's passing over.
And
is it possible we're supposed to use a light and then cover it a little bit? Like when we went to the library.
That's what it seems like. It looks like it might want us to mimic that eclipse, maybe. That'd be my guess, anyway.
And I'm gonna go back.
Is this the entranceway? That's like closed?
There seems to be like a part of this dome that could roll away, but it seems shut at the moment.
Okay.
So
then.
Yeah, what are these pillars made of?
As you look, these are flat, very finely hewn stone pillars, constructed, you know, in this triangular fashion. And as you kind of look around, on one of the sides of these pillars, there is a word written in Elvish.
I do not speak Elvish. Does anyone speak Elvish?
I do.
Yay!
What them words say?
It says reveals. It's a single word of Elvish.
Reveals.
Check the other ones. See if, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Are you checking them all, Zay?
Yes.
Then going from bottom to top, they say essential, reveals, light, sight, block.
Try shoving the pillars and see if they move.
Does the pillar move?
No.
Okay.
Essential, reveal.
You said you have torches, Angel.
Yeah. Then Angel will take out the torches. If we're supposed to be blocking things, I don't know how useful they'll be, but I have them.
Well, I think we need a source of light. Perhaps cast shadow? I mean, my hands can probably mimic the crescent.
Where's the sun about, like, in relation to us?
To the east. So, right side of the map.
Okay. Hmm. This one was the light pillar, correct?
That one, this would be the light pillar.
Oh, okay. Does touching the pillar do anything?
No.
No? Zay, what if you say the word out loud in Elvish?
Light. In Elvish.
Unfortunately, you are not the Christian God. Saying light does not create light.
Okay. Then, yeah, try lighting a torch near the sphere?
Or by this pillar. One of the two.
One of the two.
Does Karen have illusion magic?
Yep.
That can create lights as well.
I mean, it's not real light. I'm just simulating light.
Well, oh, great.
I mean, Angel will go ahead and strike up one of the torches. Yeah.
Okay.
I guess kind of casting that light over here, maybe waving the torch around. Does that anything seem to happen?
Nope.
Can I put my hand in front of the flame?
Yeah, you put your hand in front of the flame a bit. Make a mental check, Charon.
Exceptional mind?
Yeah.
Yay.
I will reroll one for funsies.
Do you want hero points to reroll another one?
If you want.
Sure.
Three.
Looking, it doesn't seem like the gemstones that are placed in here are magic in any way, but they are very precisely cut, you're realizing. And putting your hand over a torch is not the precision needed in order to open this place.
Colin.
Mm-hmm?
You know how you can use, like, lenses to magnify, like, light?
Yeah.
George is gonna take out the binoculars and try and, like, see if he can get the sunlight to go through them.
You are able to kind of like partially focus the light, but also Charon and probably George eventually would figure out like the just sole focusing of light here isn't the only part of this equation.
What were the words again?
Essential reveals light sight blocked. Would it be essential light reveals blocked sight?
Looking at
sight blocked essential reveals light.
Looking at the gemstones when the light is focused on them, does anything change about them? Like something reflected in them or...
I mean, they seem to funnel the light downward.
Okay.
Question. Is from the top of the dais, can you see the top of the pillars?
How tall are you?
7'5".
You would be able to see just the bare kind of tops of the pillars, yeah.
Okay. What's on top of the pillars?
As you look up there and kind of glance, on top of each of these pillars, appears to be a gemstone, maybe a diamond of some sort, with some very faintly glowing runes about them.
Okay.
Oh, I can maybe read those.
Yeah.
Or at least gather information.
Also, can someone try and touch one of the pillars while I'm looking to see if the runes change at all?
I touch the pillar.
Doesn't change.
Okay, just making sure. I mean, I can try and lift Charon up.
Charon can float.
Well, I mean, I would have to...
They would have to transform.
Expend something for that. So, if I could be held up, that's dope. Mm-hmm. Can I look at the runes and see what's what?
Yeah, looking at these, the runes seem to detect light. Like, they just, like, the surrounding ambient light level. And, like, that detection method appears to be, like, the diamond, which is tied to these runes. So it looks like these pillars, at least part of their purpose is to make sure the surrounding light level is at a certain point of, like, a diminished level.
If I create the illusion of light next to them, does anything happen?
It appears like the runes, like, flash and, like, light up a bit as they are, like, detecting the light, and they're probably sending a signal, if you had to guess, to this raised dais somehow, maybe by an underground system.
Hmm.
Can you try blocking the sensors?
Like covering them?
Yeah. Like the one you're being held up to?
I toss my hat on it.
Yeah, you toss it and it seems like based on how the runes are reacting, it picks it up. Like definitely they are being blocked. But it's not correct. It's like it's a little too dark.
Okay, can we block the one that says block? Put light next to the one that says light? Does that seem to get us anywhere?
Both are wrong. No.
Gotcha.
Both don't seem to hit that perfect sweet spot.
And what's
would
the...
Would I be able... How big is this area? Not more than... What is my branch?
100 feet.
Visual image contained within a 50-foot cube, so I don't think I could get all of them.
Get three of them.
Or at least, if I flew up here... I would probably be able to get all of them. I don't actually know.
No, because it's... 50-foot cube.
So 25 for you.
25.
Oh, okay, yeah.
We said the hat was too dark. Maybe you could do an illusion to kind of create, you know, dim light instead of covering it entirely, maybe?
Or that sort of half moon. Or what was the light look like up there?
Crescent.
A crescent moon?
Yeah. See that?
Like a shadow-shaped crescent.
Yeah, it could be it only opens like a certain day of the year.
Would I be able to try mimicking the amount of light that would pass through a crescent shape? Or that would pass around, I guess?
Make a mental check at benefit one.
Oogie.
Eight.
Three?
Okay. On top of the dais, it seems to be depicting an eclipse. And there is no such thing as a crescent moon during an eclipse. Because, like, it's a kind of a full thing. So You could do it as like a crescent sun or a partial eclipse if you would like.
I can do... Can I do the light in the shape of a crescent and then also do what it would look like if there was an eclipse? You know, the ring of light around?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So
I'll try both.
The first attempt doesn't really get you anywhere. The second attempt seems to send positive signals to the dais as the runes are reading it as the correct light level. It seems like they respond to the light level that would be around ambiently during a full solar eclipse.
So it's like the stages almost?
But it goes, once I take that away, it
goes, yeah.
Is done?
Mm-hmm.
How many illusions can you have at once?
Well, it has to be within a 50-foot cube, so like...
If you can get those three, I think everyone else might be able to...
Yeah, does anyone have, like, paper that we can cut into circles and hold over these?
George has his files. He'll volunteer them.
Aw.
Yeah, I can take care of... I think from the cube it looked like I could take care of the ones over here.
Gotcha. Then you could certainly, if you're throwing up your illusion again, cover those three, and they all go green. Golden.
Okay.
Maybe Altair can put George up on one of them, and then Altair can cover the other.
Yeah, I mean, I could lift George up to one and then try and lift someone else to cover the other.
Like, I can go up on one if you can lift me.
Yeah.
Gotcha. So you are trying to cover up these different pillars to get the light level exactly right, correct?
Yeah.
Yep.
Gotcha. Then both of you make mental checks at benefit one. It's like you have material, it's about finding the correct way to hold these things so that you get it perfectly correct.
This was George and I, correct?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Oh, okay.
I'm gonna spend.
Hey, you at least got your whole
hero points just for funsies.
Hey, there you go. Hey, bye.
That's all successes for me.
Gotcha. Then both you and George are able to like look at the light levels, and George, you're able to basically like copy what Angel is doing as well, as you're covering up these diamonds and making sure that the perfect amount of light is being provided. And as this happens, Key, you begin to see a change in the dais begin. You watch as that perfect amount of like light begins to seemingly like hit the different gemstones, because remember, it's like the gemstones themselves are just trying to get light that's focused in. And as the sun is kind of setting at the moment and coming through the pillars at the right angles, and the light is getting hit into this place, you watch as it starts to separate, and there appears to be now a spinning wheel filled with elvish lettering on it that opens up in front of you, activated due to the like faking of the light level that is happening in the area.
Come up here, please.
Yippee.
Then
I read
Gotcha. You re-taking a look at everything. And so then, this is what y'all would see. You able to see that?
Not
where?
No.
In front of the screen here. Let me see here. Should be showing up now to all of you.
I don't see anything yet.
Let's see. Trying to look. Yeah, it should be showing.
It's where we just get smited.
Is it supposed to be in the middle?
Yeah, just right there in the
middle. There's just still a circle.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
No words.
It's attempting to unlock Derelict Monument's lock.
Can you click that and see anything?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, there we go. Oh, that's cool.
Oh, that's neato.
Mm-hmm. There we go.
What are you guys doing?
No, click the thing in the chat.
In the... Oh, I didn't see the thing in the chat.
Oh.
How does this work?
9 attempts. Yep. Okay, so don't touch anything.
As you translate, it says 9 attempts, and there are kind of these, like, spinning tumblers of Elvish lettering. If you click on one of the letters, it will switch, like, moving. And if you attempt to unlock and you click it, an attempt will be used.
Okay. So, 5 with the 5 letters on the monument. So we have to figure out what kind of order this is in.
So,
my suggestion was block sight reveals essential light.
Yeah, I think it should be either one of these.
Because I have an ego, I'm gonna try mine first.
No, I think that's a good guess.
So how do I do this without doing an attempt on it? I can just click on the letter?
Yeah, you can just click on the letter.
Okay. So B and then what's the next one?
B.
S.
Fuck, I don't know my alphabet.
M-N-O-P-Q-R-S.
Okay. What's the next one?
R. So right before S.
Fuck!
No!
Give me a second here.
I thought
you meant after.
The one I sent might also be a possible one. I know it doesn't make sense being read out loud, but when he read them out to us, he read from bottom to top, so this is when it's put top to bottom. The way, I don't know.
Alright. B-S-R-E-L. Do we want to try this one?
Yeah.
Then
I don't see why not.
On the right side, attempt unlock.
I will click it.
Okay.
That's
what tells us what we got right.
Or
well, you got wrong.
That's what it.
What is there, but is not in the right place.
And okay.
Green will show you what is in the right
place. Okay, so it's
that kind of puzzle. But the thing is, though, like, any letter could be in one of those letter spots. We just know that there's an R.
Mm-hmm.
But we know that there's no B, no S, no E, no L.
Correct.
Hey, hold on. Let me get the notes out. Gotta write some stuff.
Colin, does, like, closing my eyes, like, make anything appear? Looking around with my eyes closed?
Yes, actually. You close your eyes and you see geometric patterns and shapes, like these weird fuzzy dots. And it's just what happens when you close your eyes really tight.
Oh, dang.
Goodness.
You fight all kinds of excited, Colin. You know, he's suffering from blood loss, so...
God, that was so funny.
Wait, yeah, okay.
So BS, E, and L are not there. R is, but not in the middle.
Right.
You want to try R first and maybe just go with... or I guess, what do those things relate to?
Block, sight, radio.
Oh, eclipse? No, we don't have an E. Fuck.
Or an L or an S.
Eclipse doesn't have an R in it.
Yeah, Calm down, I'm special. I'm thinking loudly here.
Long sight reveals essential light.
Is our clock still going?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
Oh, how much longer do we have?
Do we
have an amount of time left.
Do we want to just go for a couple, just go for something else, see what letters we get? Since we have eight attempts.
I'm guessing it's an actual word.
I say we try all the vowels. That might get us in the right direction. Yeah, let's try all the vowels. And we don't even need to keep... I mean, we can move R if we want to.
Yeah, we'll move R just to see.
And then we don't need E either.
We don't need E, no.
Well, I mean, if we're just testing out letters, then maybe don't even put R in at all since we already know it's there. We might.
Yeah, but we should just...
But we don't know if it's in a position. Is that, that's right. A V, not a U.
That is not a U.
Hi.
Why are we at Q?
I don't know. I was trying to touch it. Someone else wanted to touch it. I hit it on V. This V is a vowel.
V is not a vowel, Brandon.
A, E, I, O, U, and sometimes Y. But we don't
Fine. I'll sit over here.
So why should we leave R in the middle? We should
try to figure out where it's I was trying to put R towards the backside. Someone else took over.
Well, let's think about where R would be in a word.
Either at the end or at the very beginning. Or maybe
so that
the
means the middle R needs to turn into an A.
Yeah. Oops. Oh my gosh. Wait, there's no Z?
There's no Z.
Oh. Interesting. Okay, well, let's try this. Interesting, there's no Z.
Alright, one person, click it. I'm gonna say Peter.
Peter's taking over.
Okay, so there's an I and an R.
I and an R, but they're both wrong. Okay, so
R in front?
I'm thinking R in front, then I?
Yeah.
Third or last.
There not being a Z is a hint. I'm trying to think.
Right.
And there weren't. Sorry, go ahead.
I'm still half stringing the thought together, but it feels like it might be a cipher. Like, I feel like maybe some substitution ciphers might drop the Z or something, or drop specific letters. I don't know enough about ciphers to really say, but...
I like the word right. I don't think that has anything. Oh, I guess E.
Right does not
right.
have any.
B-R-I.
God damn, I'm gonna shut my mouth. I'll stay over in my corner. I know my place.
R-I-G-H-T?
Yeah.
Those are all letters we haven't used.
B-R... that's six.
It's too many letters. But I was thinking you were saying right as in like right and wrong.
What are you talking about?
R-I-G-H-T. Right is five that's letters. Five.
Good lord.
Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, no, Kenan said bright with the B.
No. No.
Then, yeah, that doesn't work.
Do you want to try right as in right and wrong?
I guess so.
Come on, so essential light.
Oops. Oh, wait, we already... No, we didn't. Yeah, this should be good. Kenan, do you want to lock it in?
Okay.
R-I-G-R-H-H-T.
Interesting, but the four of them are in the wrong spot. Okay.
So, I is not first or second, R is not middle or third, fifth or first.
Could it be T-H-I-R something? Like third? Have we done D? Third for D? No, we haven't.
Hasn't happened, no.
Well, let's try and...
That could be it. I mean, the number three is... I don't know if it is in this context, but it's generally important.
Oh, wait, and everything's in the shape of a triangle. So three sides.
I like it. We got attempts.
We don't. What? What are we doing?
Third.
Third.
Third. T H I.
It'll be different places.
Yeah.
Oops. Thank you.
Ah.
Okay.
I could have too fast and it doesn't work.
Yeah. Who wants to lock it in?
Angel.
Oh, okay. I'll do it.
Yay!
Oh, shit.
As you
nice.
Lock it in, you feel kind of this rumbling occur as the kind of raised altar descends, and then it seems to slowly turn sideways and open up, revealing a staircase that descends deeper into this monument.
Well, let's go, everybody. Also, this... I don't know why, but I'm getting on the third day he rose again from the dead with the rolling stone away from the opening. The triangle for the Holy Trinity, and I'm afraid.
If I drop my illusion, it doesn't just shut?
It does not, no. But the opening's here. It's not here.
Yeah, I don't know where you're going.
Oh.
The thing descended.
What's in
there? Oh, so we still don't know what this is yet.
I want in.
You well, want in? Okay.
Look down.
It's a staircase.
Oh.
A dolphin dive in. Down.
Oh, great. And we're still on the Clock of Doom.
Oh.
You love the Clock
It didn't
Doom.
Close behind us.
Did not.
It's like Fear and Hunger.
But as you make your way down the path, you're able to see what appears to be like a casket or a tomb of some sort, with three different hallways jutting off in all directions.
Ooh, before we continue, could I take 1 minute to give somebody 26 stamina points?
Sure, who?
Oh, okay. Shit.
I don't know if you want to, like, wait.
It's just 1 minute. Should be okay, right?
You might want to do Altair. I think he's down at zero.
Yeah, I'll give that to you, Altair.
Hey, you know what Zay's gonna do?
Altair, you get nothing. Sorry.
Get nothing? Okay.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
That's...
Really?
Well, that was a good test. I was about to pop off three heals.
As okay. As like, the energy is just dissipated into you don't know where.
Commander, permission to open the door.
What does the casket have on it?
Looking at it, it appears to be made out of like a very fine type of wood, with more like darker elements to it.
Is there any writing or anything on it?
No writing on it, no. Seems to have a very heavy lid, though.
What's, to take a page out of Viola's book, what's the vibe in here?
I like the vibe.
The vibe here for you specifically is that of energy. Like, it's almost as if, like, you're moving easier, quicker. Like, just overall more lively.
Colin, can I pop that 25 stamina points on myself?
Sure. You get nothing.
Fuck! Worth it.
Hey, Angel, do you feel that?
Yeah, I do.
You do? Okay, well, that settles it then. Is there a particular area that feels stronger, or is it just kind of, it's all over?
It's all over.
Okay.
Door, I guess.
Yeah, I might, actually suggest that I open doors, if that's okay.
I think I'll be fine opening them too.
Okay.
I would like to attempt to open door.
Yeah, then as you push the door open, you see a large chamber inside that appears to be filled with all these sorts of urns, like statues, ceremonial medals and coins, jewels and treasures here. It is a hall of relics, basically.
Okay. Don't touch anything.
Yep, but basically anyone... lots of wealth and treasure.
Mm-hmm.
Should we check the... Can I look around for any sign of what this is for, specifically? Who this was for?
Sure. Make a mental check.
One success.
You don't know. Judging by it, maybe some sort of warrior, priest? You're not sure. You would see that there does appear to be more elvish writing in here on some of the coins and medals and other parts. There are parts of the writing, though, that you're like, man, that's missing a letter, or that's spelled a little bit weird. There's not a Z in here.
Not a single one.
Mm-hmm. Huh.
Mm-hmm.
Say, do these say anything of interest?
I go through and read.
All of it?
No, just a couple where Charon is.
I mean, it's like Medal of Honor or to commemorate like our victory. The future is with us. Elven blood, elven strength. Like there are all these mottos and things here.
I just want to remind everybody that last time we came to a place like this, we didn't take anything and I got kidnapped. So maybe we should change those things.
Take stuff and don't get kidnapped?
Yes.
We are on a clock, so let's try and look through all the doors before we touch anything.
Mm-hmm. Can I open this door?
Sure. As you open this new door, you look and you can see floor to ceiling. There is a map here of what appears to be the landscape of the Omen Weald.
Shit.
Oh.
And you're like, oh. Like, you just got the map now.
Woo!
Fantastic. Write it down.
And as you start...
He's got good eyes. Memory.
As you start, like, writing all of it down, there appears to be, like, shapes in the landscape and in the topography. Like, even this valley itself is in the middle of this kind of triangular geographic formation with the point, the very center of this dimension, being 19 miles northwest of Widowstone at what appears to be like a tower of some sort.
That's very interesting. Okay. So I'm assuming we got the map.
Yep, you got
the map. Open door.
Open that door?
Yeah.
All right. Then as you go up to it and you push inside, immediately you feel power start to radiate out, Zay. As floating here in the middle of this room is a jet black sphere floating amongst swirling aether, finely carved out of perhaps obsidian with streaks of gold, silver, platinum, titanium, and dozens of other metals running from its base all the way up to the spear point. Which maybe not be obsidian. In fact, it seems to be a convergence of all these different veins of metal. Dozens and dozens of metals finely crafted and hewn together into this one perfect point. And I think, Zay, as you look at the base of this structure, you'd see the name of this item, Tradothan. And as it spins in place, giving off waves of power, it is truly the most remarkable and finely crafted weapon you have ever seen.
Weapon, you said?
It's a spear, yes.
It's a spear.
Is a spear not a weapon, Caleb?
Oh, I thought you were saying sphere, like round object.
Can I attempt to...
check for traps?
check for traps and just like try to understand.
What did you say it was magic? Called?
Tradothan.
Tradothan.
Here, let me...
Can I get spelling on that?
Of course you can.
Oh, I spelled that so wrong.
Yeah, so did I. That's why I was like...
So can I try to check for traps on it? Magical traps, and then like maybe get a gauge for power? Strong this damn thing, yes.
Make two different mental checks, and the second one might benefit one.
Okay.
We do have to move.
Yeah, sorry.
exactly. No, you're good. I'm not trying to rush you. I'm just mentioning that the clock is running out.
There's the first one, and then the second one.
No traps that you can detect.
Aye. And three for its kind of significance.
Significance or power?
Power.
Very powerful. And with three, this thing's dormant now.
Mm. Oh, it's dormant and this is powerful?
Does it recognize the name?
Yeah, is it recognizable to either of us?
No. Zay, you would be able to pick up on with three successes, though. Amongst its tags, looking at it and how fine the point is, this is a sharp 5 spear.
Oh.
Oh, shit.
So, we have to try and take it, right?
Yeah.
Is there anything else in this room?
Yeah.
No, nothing else that you can see.
Okay. Do we want to kind of do a team effort of try to grab as many relics as you can, and I'll attempt to grab the spear?
Yeah, so we should have someone go and check for traps in the relic room.
Looking in the relic room, is there anything that looks like it could be connected to the spear?
The spear? No.
Okay. Okay. Could we start collecting relics?
Sure.
Do you want to check
traps? They're collecting relics. And emeralds, too, that are amongst the treasures.
Nice.
Are you trying to take it all?
I'll start helping take things. Charon's going to quietly thank the individual who lays here, I guess.
Okay.
And be like, we are kind of trying to save the world. I really hope you don't mind. Sorry.
Make a spirit. It'll be put to good use.
Okay. Two.
Okay. Thank you.
Do you want hero points on that?
If you want. I mean, I'll throw one in if you want to.
Yeah, I can give you 4 hero points just for funsies, so you can have 2 rerolls.
Okay. I'll reroll 3 then, if that's cool.
Mm-hmm.
3.
Okay. Oh, my apologies. You should have had benefit 1 on this as well.
Okay, so...
4.
4. Then, as you kind of give the prayer... You feel that energy in the room kind of begin to grow, Charon. And as it does, all of you feel this place shake. And as you look around and kind of like try to pick up on the energy, it doesn't seem angry at you, Charon. But you just pick up on the fact of just, like, pain, hurt, as there is, like, a connection to you. And as you kind of begin to tap your foot on the floor, just trying to think, you look down at your body, and it's very, very solid.
And
Key, as you look, Charon doesn't seem nearly as ghostly as they did but moments ago. They seem very solid.
Where's Charon's book?
One of us, I assume, has it.
Probably on Angel.
Angel, yeah.
Charon, last time you were solid, it was very, very bad. Do you think we need to close your book?
When I was solid? Huh?
Yes.
When?
When you were him.
I mean, I don't know. I don't, feel near us or anything, do I?
No.
I mean, he doesn't...
So...
I think it's fine. I think we should just hurry.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah,
okay. Carefully grab relics.
Yeah,
collecting relics and emeralds.
Gotcha.
They seem hurt. I don't know.
Then you can clear out the relic hall, follow some relics and emeralds and other treasures.
Yay.
Do we want to try and open the casket?
I was thinking about it, but that I don't know. It feels all of this is disrespectful, but
how's they doing?
Zay, what are you doing?
I'm just kind of waiting for a signal to grab the spear for us, be finally ready to go.
It's covered in pure aether, right?
Like swirling aether.
Okay. I could probably create an opening for you.
You can reach through it. It's more mist than anything.
Yeah. Oh, so it's not,
it's not an aether shield.
Okay, I was imagining the aether shield from before. Not this campaign.
Not what I said, yeah.
Sorry.
Before you guys grab and we start doing things that might shake this all up, can I bend down to the coffin?
Sure.
Is there something you need still?
You just feel a sense of hurt and then anger. And then you get this shock of intent, of hurt, and all you can decipher it as is revenge. Whatever this entity is, they want revenge.
Me? Someone I know?
Someone you know. It's getting closer to the answer, yeah.
Is it...
Well, the C's missing. Oh, sorry, I'm not in the room.
Is it the one who made me?
You don't know.
Oh, I'm talking to it.
Yeah, you don't know. Yeah, you can't get any sort of read on what their answer would be.
Open the casket or no? Because we need to leave.
How much time is left?
Not a whole lot.
Hmm.
I mean, does it look openable? Or is it pretty
It's a heavy casket, as I said. Yeah. But
yeah.
Hey, if everyone puts their back into it, maybe.
I think we have enough. I don't want to desecrate.
Yeah, just out of curiosity, is the casket dusty or anything?
It is dusty, yeah.
And I think Angel's not trying to open it or anything, but they'll try to dust it off. Probably won't soothe much, but maybe a little bit of care will help them.
Mm-hmm. And I think as you do that, red lettering would appear along the casket as you touch it. In Elvish.
Oh boy.
Ooh.
I read.
You read. Okay. Looking at it then, as you read it, it says, you kind of squint for a second, then you read again, and your blood kind of starts to go a bit cold. Here lies Beatrix, third Dorcha Arex.
Oh, fuck.
No.
Oh, no. Do I know anything about the third Dorcha?
Probably not.
Yeah. I understand. I know what you... I get it. We're gonna do our best.
I'm sorry, Beatrix. Rest well.
Yeah.
Right. We ready?
Grabbing the spear and going?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you, Beatrix, as Zay goes to grab the spear.
Mm-hmm. As you... Thank you. Grab hold and take the spear itself, you feel power kind of quake in this space as you twirl Tradothan in your hand. It's yours. You have it, and it's just thrumming with power.
All right, quickly, we need to go.
Yeah.
I'm assuming we got the map all down.
Yeah.
Okay. Then yeah. Let's leave.
Alright.
Oh, before we go, I still have some flowers from the meadow we found the maiden in. I imagine they've probably dried by this point. Can I leave one?
Sure.
Yeah. Really quick. Was there a slot anywhere on this mound?
No.
Okay.
And Charon, as you look at it, you think that's the guard dog.
Ah.
What? Oh.
Okay, time to leave.
It closes back up once we get out of there, right?
As all of you begin to leave, it slowly begins to start closing back up, yes.
Nice.
Mm-hmm.
I give it a bow before I head out. Am I ghosty again?
As you exit out, yes, you are ghosty again.
I don't know. I don't know who I should be thanking at this point.
It's cool.
And do you leave?
Yep. Yeah.
Alright. As you leave, I'm assuming you are all heading back to camp. The Widow's Stone.
Yeah.
And as you begin to make your way back, the relics, the spear, really all of you pulse with this energy for a long while before eventually you make your way back to Widow's Stone. And as you get within the walls, you all take a very deep breath. But you've returned. It's later at night, but a return is a return. And due to you copying down the map, you are able to get 8 intel.
Ooh. Wow!
4 double to 8.
Heck yeah.
Nice.
Then let's see, 5 emeralds doubled to 10.
Holy shit.
Thank the Lord.
I don't cheat. It was 5.
No.
Oh, hail mighty Colin. Thank you.
And
we've never had.
And 10 relics doubled to 20.
What?
Oh, yeah.
Dude, someone's got to add Marcus. Someone's got to add Marcus.
At Marcus, listen, check the relics.
Listen, can we just set 7 aside for him? Just so we don't have to deal with this later.
No, for real.
I mean, it'll be fine.
Here's your gift. 7 relics. Go crazy.
It'll come up when it comes up.
Yeah, fair enough.
Wild.
He'll do his thing when he does his thing.
It's, crazy. I can't read a 24-hour clock. What is this?
Just minus 2.
A what?
What?
Minus 12. It's... Shit, 9 o'clock?
Okay. Like 9:30?
Oh shit, I left Foundry.
There we go.
We should go, someone should go let Mace Crane that we're back.
Say, do you want to have Magion or Karania look at the spear?
I can take care of that in the coming days.
I don't know, that it looks really important. I'm not sure if any of us should use it.
I don't know if we'd want to pass it on to anyone who takes it is, well, they're going to have motives for it.
We could have Karania look over it for curses. I'm sure that's something she is able to do.
I think that's smart. And we'll talk to also... Marie. Maybe? I don't know. I'm just worried with something that powerful, if it were to be used outside of Wood of Stone, it would make detection, you know, go up.
This is also a question we can ask.
Mm-hmm.
Does it have to be now?
And did anyone here recognize that name?
I feel like
Dorchard, right?
You make a mental check, probably not a great chance of it.
Okay.
We would at least know what a Dorcha is, right?
Oh, the Dorcha or Rex? Yeah, you would know that.
Okay. Yeah, I'm making sure.
What all would you fucking hell about that?
4 successes.
4 successes. Beatrix was a Dorcha.
My guess is some elven heritage there?
From your recollection, yes, she was an elf. Came about about a little more than a century after the first Dorcha. Maybe closer to 2 centuries.
Yeah, she probably wants revenge for the death of Sin.
Likely.
Oh, she was also the third one.
From your recollection, Zay, pretty powerful Dorcha.
Yeah.
One of the quote-unquote problem Dorchas.
Oh, Carwin died in the... At least it says that it destroyed himself, the Dorcha Rex, and Sin's army when defeat seemed inevitable. Mm-hmm. Damn.
Well, my 2 cents is Magion probably doesn't need this. That's all I think.
I can trust, the goddess more, personally.
I think it's Zay's decision.
Mm-hmm. I'm open to ear to people. To hear what others have to say is the words I'm looking for.
I'd say at least the goddess look at it.
Yeah, if you're consulting anyone, I believe the goddess would probably be the better option.
Magion might just simply confiscate it, lock it away.
I agree with that assumption. Himself.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily agree he'd use it himself, but he definitely would probably lock it away.
Probably. But Corania, at the very least, she might still confiscate it, but she would actually give us an explanation.
Yeah. I mean, I'm fine with holding on to it until we do a downtime. Then I can scoot on over there.
Oh, sure, that works.
All right, well, I have a lady to make sure eats. So, good night, everybody.
First thing, before anything else, I'd like to ask, so Zay, are you keeping Dridothan?
Yes.
I've added it to your items then.
Yippee.
The dormant version, at least. Oh, God.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Brandon, do you want to share?
Is there time for Angel to go see Radovan?
Now? Probably not.
I need to go speak to my associate. So.
Oh!
I don't say that out loud. Charon doesn't say that out loud.
Something the matter, Brandon?
Listen, I'm already on the first sentence. It's pretty funny already.
I want to know.
I guess George will let Mace Crane know. Mission was a success.
Gotcha.
Just walks over with a whole bunch of emeralds and relics in a bag. And a map in tow.
Just signing.
Drops it at his feet.
Put the relics in the bag.
Just put the fries in the bag, bro.
And 15 emeralds. Look at that, gang.
Oh, it's so nice.
It's gorgeous.
All we need is to get our morale up a little bit, our supplies up a lot, and we would be ready to move whenever we needed to. But of course, stick around until we have to. But, so nice to have emeralds at 15. We don't have to worry about that for a little bit.
Then, at this point, as you all move back to your regular state of being, much to do and think about, it is here where we will end the session for today. As all the children of Sin may take a level up.
Ooh.
That's incredibly unfortunate. I don't think Goliath.
No.
No.
Are children of Sin.
Am I?
You are considered one, yes.
Okay.
I'm assuming Key is not, but there's always weirdness that may or may not happen.
No, you are not one. Yeah.
Okay, I did not think so, and I was kind of hopeful it was not.
I'm special.
You are very special.
What, you don't like Sin? You a Sin hater?
I can't fuck with Sin haters, man.
I should be doing more Sin.
I hope Mace Crane gave you berries, George. Right, so he gave you many. Yay.
I have to go.
Au revoir.
Au revoir.
Woo! We got stuff. We almost got eaten by Vore, but we got everything.
You got everything.
Jonah doesn't like my rat.
I don't know why.
Yeah, why dude, I mean, listen. You see my rat memes. I love the rat.
I love how both Charon and B now have a rat.
Yes.
You crave the rat.
I haven't decided on a name, though. It's really difficult. It took me like real live months to name most of my animals, so like real live animals.
Oh, I love that. You know, it's really personal.
Yeah.
This weapon's cool as fuck.
So yeah. Colin, I have a question.
Mm-hmm.
Do people put their martial school abilities on their character sheets? Or do they just flip back and forth between this and, like, the items?
Like, I will sometimes, like, just give people the thing, like, as a power in that format, technically, because it's not really a power, but...
Okay.
Like, I leave it up to you if you want it as a power or in the items.
I'll probably put it there so that way I don't have to go through so many.
Mm-hmm. That does
there
how I have
as
it.
In terms of powers or...
Yeah, on the
yeah,
powers
okay, yeah, yeah.
thing.
Okay. Here, I have it formatted for that. I can just...
Yay!
Throw it in your sheet.
Thanks.
Mm. Oh, Colin, that's actually a change I need to make. For the mountains that I have in my item list, it shows what my next options are.
Mm-hmm.
What is the fifth option?
Let me see here.
Is that the special land one, or?
No. The fifth mountain is a mountain dedicated to perseverance and never giving up.
Okay, I like that.
That is its nature. That is what it do.
I like that one a lot. I might work on that one.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice, nice, nice. And here, actually.
And if I get 5, 4, 8, 7, 9, I can get to the last mountain.
Last mountain.
I start drooling.
I believe the last mountain needs 2 in order to get there. You need to go from both sides to get last mountain.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I listed everything. Mm-hmm. I think it also needs the ninth mountain, which is in
probably.
Between the eighth and the seventh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But good stuff's up there. I can feel it.
It is. It's very good stuff. Only the best.
Can you only use a Nile once? Per, like, whatever?
So, for some, yes. For others, no.
Okay.
The first Nile being the base, you can use it multiple times. And you can use it with other Niles.
Multiple times. Okay, go. Yippee.
Were we still planning on doing, like, a game night tonight?